Good morning, everybody. Good morning. Welcome to Cowichan Grace Church Sunday online worship service. Yeah, it's always good to have you to worship God together. Yeah, so church, let's gather our heart together and give him praise to the good Father of us. Let me just open with prayer. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, we thank you. We thank you that you are here with us. And we thank you again that you are hear us and speak to us. Thank you, Lord. We just come before you, Lord. We can stand here and worship you because you have opened the way to the Father. So now we boldly approach the throne of grace because the blood of Jesus has been poured out. Your blood paid for everything. So we have full access to come before God as sons and daughters. We want to sing of you. We want to sing of all you've done for us. We want to praise your precious name. Come and receive all our praise. It's only for you, Lord. We lift you up, King Jesus. We exalt you and all your glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Let's sing together.
Would you be free from your burden of sin? There's power in the blood, power in the blood. Good, good or evil, a victory win. There's wonderful power in the blood. There is power. There is power, power, wonder-working power in the blood of the Lamb. There is power, power, wonder-working power in the precious blood of the Lamb. Would you be free? Would you be free from your passion and pride? There's power.
Power, power, wonder-working
breaks the power of sin and darkness, whose love is mighty and so much stronger. The King of glory, the King of over kings, who shake the whole earth, who shake the whole earth with holy thunder, who lifts us
Let's bow down before God and pray. Before we pray together, I want you to listen to Psalm 46. God is our refuge and strength, an ever-present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth give way, and the mountains fall into the heart of the sea, though its waters roar and foam, and the mountains quake with their surging. There is a river whose streams make glad a city of God, the holy place where the Most High dwells. God is within her. She will not fall. God will help her at break of day. Nations are in uproar. Kingdoms fall. He lifts his voice. The earth melts. The Lord Almighty is with us. The God of Jacob's. Jacob is our fortress. Come and see the works of the Lord, the desolation he has brought on the earth. He makes wars cease to the ends of the earth. He breaks the bow and shatters the spear. He burns the shields with fire. Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord Almighty is with us. The God of Jacob is our fortress. Amen. When you pray to God, and I want to pray for the nations, all nations. So many unbelievers, they don't know Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, and our refuge and our strength. They are not forgiven if we have no blood of Jesus Christ. And this morning, I meditate Exodus chapter 8. God said to Moses, tell the Pharaoh, let my people go so that they may worship me. Satan, our enemy, blinded our friends and our brothers and sisters. Their eyes blocked by the Satan, so they cannot see the glory of Jesus Christ, the gospel of glory. So we pray for them. Father, lose their eyes and they can see. Enlighten their eyes and see the glory of the gospel of Jesus Christ. So let them come to you, Jesus. You can pray for one another who are in the hospital sick. Pray for them. Who are in trouble, pray for them. Who are in deep depression because of this pandemic time, pray for them. And pray for this worship service. Ask Holy Presence. When we feel and believe He is with us, our worship is success because our Lord receives our worship and honor and glory. Let's pray together with Holy Spirit. Oh, thank you, Father God. We come to you, the throne of grace now, Father, because we have the blood of the Lamb. Father, I ask you, Lord, your beloved Son's blood covers all our church family who worship now. We apply the blood of Jesus Christ. All our friends and brothers and sisters and our family who didn't know Jesus Christ, the Heavenly Father. Let their eyes open and see your glory. The glorious gospel of Jesus Christ, when they see you, let them come to you. And this morning you said to the Moses, tell the Pharaoh, let my people go, so that they worship me. Father, we pray for the unbelievers. They are not forgiven yet. So we pray for them, Lord, Father God. All the bind things like losing. By the name of Jesus Christ, Father, let them see you. Let them hear your gospel. Let them come back to Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Our refuge and Lord, our King, our Shepherd. Oh Lord, Father God, please help us. In all the nations, when Jesus comes, we raise our hands and we lift up heaven together with you, Father. We are hoping for that, Lord God. And also in this moment, Father, in this worship service, Father, all our family, we invite you. Please come in our worship service. Wherever they are, Father, our your beloved children, Father. So now we worship with you. Jesus Christ, you are the center of our worship. You are the core of our worship service, Father God. So receive all our glory and honor. And Father, we worship you, Lord. We honor you, Father. Thank you for this worship. Oh, Heavenly Father, thank you for your glory. The Word became human being. The name is Emmanuel, Jesus Christ, our Lord. He's with us. Thank you, Father God. You never forsaken us. Thank you. You never forgotten us. You remember. You incurve our name on your palm. Thank you, Father, for your glory. And bless all our Cowichan Great Church family who listen and worship and participate this worship in Holy Spirit. Be with them, Father. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not in temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Good morning, everyone. Good morning. Good morning. God is so good all the time. Amen. Our Father God is a great God. It is almighty God and awesome God. So are you. You are children of God. Amen. We have church news. I'm so sad. Every Sunday, I can say same announcement, but I keep that in mind, and we worship our home night service, and I heard, and I got a text, and so many of our church family, we miss service in the place, in the where that we gather in 5530 River Road. Anyway, pray for one another. Until then, we gather together. And then time for offering time. Let me pray. Father, thank you. We give this offering to your hands, Father God. Accept our offering and give all the blessing of heaven to all our church family who give. So, Father, sometimes in our heart is so stingy we cannot give you. But, Lord, give us generous heart and give you this offering for you. We're going to use this offering for your kingdom. And your word spread out all the world. And thank you and bless all our church family. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Okay, time for sharing your love in Jesus Christ. Say one another, you are so beautiful, lovely, handsome, and awesome. Would you say one another, you are so awesome, yes, beautiful, handsome, lovely. I love you guys all. Love you. Okay, our today's word, the new wineskin, the parables of Jesus, number 2. Mark chapter 2, 21 to 22. We're going to read together just 2 verses. Go. No one sews a piece of shrunk cloth on an old garment, or else the new piece pulls away from the old, and the tear is made worse. And no one puts new wine into old wineskins, or else the new wine bursts the wineskins. The wine is spilled, and the wineskins are ruined. The new wine must be put into new wineskins. Everyone says, amen, amen. Father, thank you, Lord God. I bless the word and bless people who listen to your word. And Father, in this moment, by Holy Spirit, reveal the meaning of what you say this morning. And we want to know, we want to learn, we want to obey whatever you say. And Holy Spirit, with you, we live forever with joy and thanksgiving. Thank you, Father, we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. I am really terrible sense of direction. I couldn't find the ways. I don't know. This is my nature. So when I found the GPS navigation, I was so glad. With that, I can find anywhere. I can go anywhere. But one day, I going to in Vancouver somewhere, but I couldn't find a way. I just turn around and a couple of times turn around, and I'm so getting angry because I trust the GPS. You know what? I didn't update my GPS. That's why they lead me wrong ways. 2001, October, U.S. force, they attacked Afghanistan. But they bombing the storage run by UN, United Nations. So United Nations and all the world, and they were surprised. They attacked their own nations. They find a reason. What happened? Because they didn't use new map. They used old map. So they put on the wrong area, the bomb. That is 2001 October. Happened. You know, sometimes we use old map. If you want to go the way to the heaven, you need new map. What kind of new map? You know, this is very interesting. Our nature, sometimes we have positive thinking. Okay, our nature will be changed so we can be like God's children. No, what is the Bible said? Our nature of sin never changed. We die by our sin. We should be dead first. So Bible keeps saying again, born again. Born again of God. So all has passed. So old map gone. New creation comes. New map. Our new map, Jesus Christ. He became what? The way. If you are in Jesus Christ, you can go to heaven with our Lord Jesus Christ. So when you see this holy, the spiritual work and action, any kind of things, you cannot change your nature of sin. No. Not by those things. But by faith in Jesus Christ who accomplished the salvation redemption. Our today's parable talk about this. So we're going to read again. One more time. Go, no one sews a piece of unshrunk cloth on an old garment, or else the new piece pulls away from the old, and the tear is made worse. And no one puts new wine into old wineskins, or else the new wine bursts in the wineskins. The wine is spilled, and the wineskins are ruined. But new wine must be put into new wineskins. Amen. You know, actually, the word that Jesus said that, this parable, why Jesus said that? Before it happened, what happened? Jesus called the Matthew, who was tax collector. So people say the gospel, what? He said he's Messiah. The Messiah called tax collector sinner as his own disciple? But Matthew, he was glad God, Jesus called me and Jesus made me his own disciple. And you know what? Matthew, he opened party. So he invited all his family and friends and he announced that old Matthew gone. I no longer do any commit a sin. The new Matthew come. This is kind of farewell party. And this is kind of welcoming party. So everyone enjoy and eating and drinking and they happy together with Matthew and celebrate. You become the Jesus disciples. Wonderful, wonderful. There's something happened. The two teams, two groups, they question Jesus. The one group is Pharisees. The other group is disciples of John the Baptist. And the group of Pharisees, they ask you, Jesus, why you eat with these sinners. I don't get it. You are righteous one. How could you eat these terrible sinners? And what about the disciples of John the Baptist? They said, why are your disciples not fasting? We have fast twice a week, but you don't fast and you enjoy food every day like this? They're questioning two things. You know, actually, in Jesus' era, they fasting a lot. Pharisees, they fasted twice a week, the Monday and Thursday. Every Monday and Thursday, they fasting. So even though they have party, okay, today is Thursday, I'm not going to eat anything. They ruin the party. Anyway, you know, they don't get it. How could Jesus eat with the sinners? And then Jesus say that to them. This parable. You know, why we pray with fast? Do you have experienced fasting prayer? Good. If not, you can try. When you fast and pray, this God answers so many things. I experienced so many great things. The reason why we fast and pray, meaning is before God, we reveal our sin. We know our desire, our body is blocked, the loving God. So when you quit the food, you only focus your Lord God. You're crying with your sin. So fasting prayer is not for proud of yourself. Instead, you reveal to people and God, I am nobody. I have no ability to show my good things. I'm a sinner. The reason why we fast in prayer, the more we love God. But they choose the fasting prayer as their own braggness and prayer, the pride. You know what? I pray fast 10 days, 40 days, 5 days, 1 day. One day, they just pray. They just show themselves, I'm a pious and really religious person. I'm a good one. With that kind of spiritual act, they want to show themselves, not God or not loving God. And what did Jesus say then? And Apostle Paul, yeah. Apostle Paul said that 1 Corinthians 15:10, he was chosen by God as a wonderful apostle. And he did so many miracles. He planted a lot of churches. He wrote the letter of God. Yeah, super. But you want to hear his saying, what he's saying? But by the grace of God, I am what I am. What he said that? By the grace of God, or by my good spiritual work, I am what I am. No, he said, by the grace of God, I am what I am. And his grace toward me was not in vain. But I labored more abundantly than they all. He said it. I labored a lot. I labored more abundantly than they all. Yet, what? Not I. Not I. I built 100 churches. I saved a lot of peoples. And I gave a lot of, so much money. I just donated. I have 100 peoples. Maybe he did it. I labored more abundantly than they all. Yet not I, but the grace of God which was with me. Who labored? God. God's grace. Because he knew that. Who make this work? This work is by God's grace. But people who question to Jesus Christ, they kind of framed by their own religious action. And Jesus said to them this parable. No one sews a piece of unshrunk cloth on an old garment, only as the new piece pulls away from the old, and the tear is made worse. You know, these days, the clothing's very easy to get. If you tear down, you just garbage it. And you can buy $5 in thrifty store or Valley Village. Easy, right? But at the time, 2,000 years ago, you know what? When I was young, 1960 or 70 or 80, the clothes is very expensive. And then my mom and with my socks and his whole, she sewed just my old socks. Because it's precious. Clothes is very precious. But at the time, 2,000 years ago, everyone knew that nobody put old garments on a new cloth on that. Because new clothes, when you laundry, they shrink. A couple of years ago, when my daughter Jenny was little, we usually go to Valley Village to shopping, and we found a very nice hat made with wool. So nice, and it's perfect fit. Jenny's hat is so beautiful. So just $5, and wow, this is wonderful. And then, because from the secondhand stores, we just launder it. Washing this wool, we don't know what the wool is shrinked or not. And after we launder it, the head is really small, like a little baby's. It shrinked. You know what? At the time, everyone knew that. Nobody do that. This new cloth, if you washing, it shrink a little. So this old garment is tear down. Nobody do that. Everyone knows that. Then what is the meaning of this cloth? New cloth, Jesus Christ. And Jesus explained to us more understandably the next verse. That is Mark chapter 2:22. We're going to read again. Go, and no one puts new wine into old wineskins, or else new wine bursts the wineskins. The wine is spilled, and the wineskins are ruined. But new wine must be put into new wineskins. Amen, amen. You know, at the time, the Jewish people, they put water and wine into the wineskin, and the leather. This looks like that, and they cut the head and they tie with all the things and make one big bag, and they put in the water or wine, and sometimes when they go somewhere, they using this as a pillow. Yeah, but for the first time, they make this wineskin. This is look good, and it's very flexible. But after years and years and years, this is no more flexible. It's very tight. And then as you know that new wine, for the first time when you put the squeezy of the grapes, it's not wine, but it's getting fermented. It's burst. This old wineskin is burst together. You ruin all together. And Jesus say that this. Everyone knew that. Nobody do that. Old wineskin and new wine. Nobody do that because we don't know. We don't want to ruin all the things. This is a precious one at the time. Why Jesus mentioned this everyone knew this parable. You know, all the law talk about one thing. What is that? All the law talk about one thing, loving God. But with our strength, with our power, according to the law, even though you did all the things, you cannot love God with your whole heart. So with Holy Spirit and fire, we should be dead by our desire of a human being and desire of body, and we should live again by Holy Spirit. Then we can love God in Jesus Christ, who accomplished the redemption. Then you can really love God. But the summon at the time still follow all the laws, not just the meaning of the law, just the practice of the law. The law shows Jesus Christ. That law is like a shadow. So let no one judge you in food or in drink or regarding a festival or new moon or Sabbath, which are a shadow of things to come, but the substance is of Christ. What is that? All the law shows Jesus Christ. This is kind of a shadow. But people, even though the real one, Jesus Christ, came to them, they reject Jesus. They still follow all the shadows. Hebrews chapter 10, 1 said that, "For the law, having a shadow of good things to come, and not the very image of the things, can never, with these same sacrifices, which they offer continually year by year, make those who approach perfect." Think about it. Jesus Christ is our new wine. That's why Jesus said that. What? "Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him up at the last day." Jesus said that, "This is my blood." When Jesus gave the wine to his disciples, "This is my blood with covenant. You should drink my blood. You should eat my body," which means you are in Jesus Christ. You can live when you eat bread or fried bread or chicken, or every day you eat, with that you live. If you not eat, fasting for 40 days and 50 days without water, you will die. Know it. Are you eating Jesus Christ every single day, his word every single day? Then you will live. But you stop eating and drinking his body and his blood. What does the Bible say then? "Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has everlasting life, and I will raise him up at the last day." Amen. Amen. Then what is the wineskin? We have a new gospel. We have a glorious gospel. Jesus Christ come in this world. We want to put this new wine into the new wineskin. Then what is the new wineskin? Bible said that. Matthew chapter 26, 29 said, "But I say to you," Jesus said, "I will not drink of this fruit of the vine from now on until the day when I drink it new with you in my Father's kingdom." What did Jesus say there? In my Father's kingdom, new one. The wineskin is kingdom of God. And in the kingdom of God, and you are in Jesus Christ, you will live forever. And this is like the Lamb's wedding in heaven. New wine in this world cannot take. New wineskin. It shows that the kingdom of God. Then Holy Spirit, when you accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, then Holy Spirit, change your heart, kingdom of God. Because God wants you to be the member of the kingdom. So Jesus, be our king. We no longer afraid as a slave of spirit. No longer. We born again and become a children of God. We should change our heart by Holy Spirit. So Old Testament prophecy about this. Ezekiel chapter 36, 26. I will give you a new heart and put a new spirit within you. I will take the heart of stone out of your flesh and give you a heart of flesh. Our heart will be changed because we need new wineskin. Then new wine, Jesus Christ, come in our heart. Ephesians chapter 3:17 said that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith, that you, being rooted and grounded in love, what you have in your heart. In your heart, the kingdom of God, or always distressed, no hope, tears, pains. Let Lord Jesus Christ be your king. And he will reign over you. All my problems, troubles, and pains, he reigned over our life. Pharisees asked Jesus. Disciples of John the Baptist asked Jesus. And Jesus said this parable, which means, you no longer pray, you no longer fast. No, we still pray, we still fast. But our true righteousness is not from that religious act. Our true righteousness only by faith in Jesus Christ. That is new wine and new wineskin, this parable. I tell you this morning, someone drink this wine. Someone wear, put on the cloth of Jesus Christ. But someone, see now wearing and knew that, wow, new wine is good. And new cloth, wonderful. But they looking at far away, they want to follow to get that. You know, Jesus said that come. You can come in. I can come into your heart. But they said, no, not yet. But I know you. I follow you. So far away. Get a distance from God. This is kind of a religious act. Pharisees, teachers of law, and Sadducees, they do. Even though they have Jesus Christ, the core of the gospel, they have the center, the real core of the gospel of the law. In the law, Jesus Christ came, but they didn't receive him. Today, while this worship service, I believe that Jesus is with you. Even though he is with you, if you don't let him as your king, he's still outside. He knocked the door. Behold, I'm still at your outside of door. Whoever hear my voice, Open the door of your heart. I will come to you, eat with you forever. So listen what Jesus said your king say to you. He want to make your heart a kingdom of God, a new wineskin, a new wine, Jesus Christ, and live forever. He want to be with you forever. So this is time to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior and live, not just once, oh, Lord, I love you, that's all, and your life is so different. No, that is not ruling by your King Jesus Christ. You're just deceiving just by lips. Oh, Lord, I love you. Lord, I believe in you. But I believe my money. But I believe my experience. But I believe my tradition. But I believe my knowledge. I believe my background of teachings. Then no longer your confession is not a confession. If you confess that Jesus is my King, not just 1 minute, forever, then you live with him. Let him rule over you. Let him be with you. Let him love you forever. And Jesus tell them. So we hear this same parable. Then what is your response? Response like a Pharisees or disciples of John the Baptist? Or like a Matthew who committed a sin as a sinner? But he glad. He happy. He opened a party with Jesus Christ and he eat, he drink with Jesus Christ. So walk with him and drink the new wine and clothe Jesus' cloth, the white linen washed by the blood of Jesus Christ. Amen? Amen. Let's pray. Father, thank you, Lord God, in this moment we hear your voice. Thank you, Father God. Through Son Jesus Christ, you teach us every single day. And today you talk about, Father, about new wineskin and new wine. Thank you. Make our life kingdom of God. And our King Jesus Christ reign over all our life. So no longer we fear. No longer we have any kind of anxiety in our life. Because we cast all our fears and anxiety before you, Lord God. We only look into you, Father. We only worship you with gladness and thanksgiving. Thank you, Father. Receive all the glory. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and love of Father God and fellowship of Holy Spirit be with you all forever and ever. Everyone says, amen, amen. Okay, God bless you and see you next Sunday. Bye.